Now I'm heading up to north central Pennsylvania, and I'm gonna hook up with my good friend Al Hevner and chase these big woods mountain gobblers and see what we can do. This is some beautiful country up here, and I'm looking forward to chasing some turkeys.
Anywhere it wants to go.
Well, it's May 7th. We got a bird gobbling up on this steep side. It's breaking day. We got to get up there quick.
Big hemlock or something. What do you think? We gotta do something.
Thank you.
gobbler's right down this point. He's coming right now. Actually, we better sit down. He's really coming. He's getting close. We gotta get down. Called to him once we got here. He's come walking right up the road. Perfect. This hen's crazy. She's still gobbling at us. We're just sitting here talking and she's got it. She's seen us a couple times. Nuts. That was pretty awesome.
That was as cool a hunt as you can ask for.
That was awesome. That was so sweet. I was gonna let him come. I mean, I was
sitting here in the open. That's why I said, as soon as you get the chance.
Were you just like that?
Yeah.
Oh my God.
I mean, it's foggy. That helped.
Yeah, that definitely helped. If it would have been sunny or something, it would have never happened. Mm-hmm. Well, we kind of got out of the door late this morning, and was in a hurry to get up here and try to hear one of these birds I heard yesterday. Yesterday was Sunday, and I just went out listening. I heard two birds up here, and
Tried to roost them last night, couldn't get them roosted, so we just thought, well, they got to be here. They were here yesterday, so we come up here this morning, and we were going to walk out on the one. It was quite a walk to get to them off the top, and we figured, you know, we'll just try to hear them first before we commit to, you know, walking real far. We didn't want to waste a bunch of time, so just swung the car door open and heard a turkey gobble, and we weren't quite sure where it was. Just as soon as we swung the door open, he gobbled, and you could tell it was off a little ways. We didn't know where he was, but turns out he was on the steep side hill behind us, and I mean steep, like straight up and down rocks and cliffs, and not a good place for a turkey, you wouldn't think. I mean, we're on this point now. This is the nicest place up here. This is probably why he was here. This is nice here, but he was gobbling great. He was gobbling at crows, and we had a bunch of owls going, and we really, really hustled to get up to him, and it was a workout. I was out of breath pretty good. And we got set up there and got him. He was just around the hill from us. We were down on the steep side. He was on it, and wanted to get on this point, but we were pretty well level with him, maybe just above him, so I figured we better sit down here because he wasn't that far from us. So we sit down there, and Chad got ready there and started calling a little bit, and he gobbled pretty good. He didn't hit me every time, but he gobbled some, and I thought I could hear a hen a little bit. I could hear some clucking and stuff. I heard a little soft yelping, and I told Chad, I said, I think I hear a hen, and I think he has a hen with him. And he did, and I'm not sure if he had another one or what, but he kind of stayed back, and here come this hen up over. And she come right up by me. I don't know if you can tell from the footage, but she had to be like 10 yards, and come right by me, clucking, purring, and yelping, and kee-keeing, and, you know, carrying on there. And she actually worked up by me, going up the side hill. He just gobbled and gobbled and gobbled out there, didn't move much, worked down below us, worked back up up in front of us, and all around out there gobbling. And well, in the meantime, this hen worked her way back behind us, and she started getting pretty worked up and actually started gobbling. It was really cool. I never really heard that good like that, and it was really neat. And he was gobbling the whole time, and pretty soon it seemed like he was getting pretty far away, and figured it was time to scoot that hen out of there, which there you couldn't make her run. I mean, she just didn't want to leave. So we just stood up, and she kind of just stood around clucking and stuff, and we worked our way up to this point. That's where I figured be the best place to get him. And we come up here, and he was gobbling on his own down on this point, and sounded like his gobbles were getting a little bit closer each time. And I told Chad, geez, we better set up here quick. And he gobbled one last time, and he was right there. This gobbler's right down this point. He's coming right now. Actually, we better sit down.
I mean, luckily we had this fog, or I don't know if this would have happened. He would have probably seen us, because the last time he gobbled, he was right in our face, and we got set up quick there, and I never even called. I didn't have to. I knew he was coming this way, so we just sat there quiet, and Chad, he didn't even have time to get his head net or gloves on, and I mean, we just sat down quick, and he just come right up the road, and I think that hen gobbled once, maybe yelped and gobbled a little bit behind us, and he heard her, and that helped a little bit, and he come walking right up this little grassy trail, and just perfect, just like it was meant to be, so it was really cool.